Hello friends, in our previous video we have analyzed the overtaking side distance, and in this lecture we will be talking about superelevation. And before superelevation we will talk about the horizontal alignment first, as superelevation is the part of horizontal alignment. Now what is horizontal alignment? We know that any road is not always on straight path. If we need to connect two cities, generally speaking, we know that the best distance will be straight, but this is not always happen. What happens if there is any obstruction in between? Then what we do, we provide curves. Suppose this is the city and we need to link it, we provide curve. This city, we provide curve. So the alignment should not always be straight. Curves are provided, curves can be occur. So there are many factors, and based on these factors cause to change our alignment. Today we will talk about these factors. Suppose if we are on horizontal curve and this is our vehicle on this horizontal curve. What is horizontal curve? Let me tell you first. Suppose this is the road and we need to change the direction to this. So for smooth riding quality of the vehicle, the curves are provided in the change of direction is known as horizontal curves. This is the direction of movement. Let me visualize this vehicle on the horizontal curve. So see, we can see this by the free body diagram. Suppose this is any vehicle and these are the tires of this vehicle. And so we know that there is phenomena of physics that on any body which is on circular path or motion, that will subject to the centrifugal force, and that centrifugal force is responsible to push the body out from the center. We are on curve, then our vehicle pushes outwards. We can understand it by the free body diagram. Suppose this is the vehicle and these are the tires, and this is the pavement on which the vehicle is in motion, and due to this weight there are upward reactions to every tire. Suppose this is RA on tire A, suppose this is RB on tire B. And so practically when your vehicle is moving on horizontal curve, then the vehicle is subjected to two forces. And if this situation occurs, then the two forces can be possible, and those two forces are the centrifugal force that acts horizontally outwards from the CG of the vehicle, and the other force is the weight of the vehicle that acts vertically downwards from the CG of the vehicle. And due to this weight, the upward reactions occurs, as Newton's third law is applicable to everywhere, that to every action there is equal and opposite reaction. So if this situation occurs, then two effects can be possible, and those two effects are the overturning effect and the another one is transverse skidding. We will talk about them in detail. First of all, if any subjected to centrifugal force, and suppose the centrifugal force is P, then this P is equivalent to mv square upon r, and if we multiply it by the gravitational constant g, then what we get, wv square upon gr, and mg equals to w. So the centrifugal force BWV square upon GR. So this equation is for centrifugal motion of vehicle, and this W is representing the weight, and V is the velocity of this vehicle, and G is the gravitational constant, and R is the radius of this curve. Now let's first visualize the overturning effect. So if we need to counterbalance these forces, So let me consider the equilibrium. Suppose this centrifugal force is acting at height h from the pavement, and the distance between the tires is b, suppose, and this weight and this tire is a distance b by 2. So considering equilibrium, what we get, p into h equals to b by 2 into w. By taking the moment of these forces, we get p by w equals to b by 2h. And now what this equation tells us, this equation tells us the tendency of the overturning will increase if p by w is b by 2h. What is p by w? P by w is known as the centrifugal ratio. So if centrifugal ratio is equivalent to b by 2h, the tendency of overturning will increase. So in order to not to increase or to subside the overturning tendency, practically we will always consider the centrifugal ratio is to be less than the b by 2h. Unlike overturning ratio, transverse skidding is also occurs due to the centrifugal force. Now what is transverse skidding? Let me talk about the skidding. Skidding can be of two types. It can be lateral or it can be longitudinal. Now what is longitudinal skidding? Suppose this is a pavement or road, and if the body is moving in a straight line path, the skidding will be the longitudinal, and if the body is moving in circular motion, then the skidding will automatic be lateral. So here we are talking about the lateral skidding, as our vehicle is on horizontal curve. And what is transverse direction? Let me also tell you this. If the direction perpendicular to the longitudinal axis of the member is known as transverse direction. So in this case we are talking about the lateral skidding. Let me visualize first, draw the free body diagram of that vehicle on circular curve again. As we visualized before, this is P, this is W, and this is the FA, frictional force on tire A, and this is frictional force on tire B. And in case of transverse skidding, if we consider the equilibrium, or now what counterbalancing this centrifugal force, this frictional force or forces on tire A, FA, and a frictional force on tire B, FB, is counterbalancing this centrifugal force in this case. And again, the reactions we can write RA and RB. And now what is FA? FA is the frictional force due to the friction between the tires and the pavement or the road. So this FA will be equivalent to F into RA, and this FB we can write as F into RB, and this F may be the frictional coefficient. Frictional coefficient we can consider as F or mu, but we consider as F. So now by considering the equilibrium, what we get, equilibrium of this free body diagram, what we get, P is equivalent to FA plus FB, and this FA and FB we can write as FRA plus FRB, and equals to F common RA plus RB, and V equals to FW we can write as RA plus RB as W, as W is counterbalancing by these two reactions. So we can consider equally, this W is equally opposite to RA plus RB, so we will consider RA plus RB as W. So we get here the centrifugal ratio P by W again as equivalence to frictional coefficient. So what this equation tells us, if the centrifugal ratio is equivalent to coefficient of friction, then the chances on danger or the skidding is more. And for design aspects, the P by W should always be less than F. Now a few more things I want to discuss with you. Suppose this is the horizontal curve and this is the vehicle and this is the inner edge of the pavement and this is the outer edge of the pavement and this is the direction of movement. So due to centrifugal force, as this vehicle is moving in this direction and the centrifugal force pushes this vehicle outward, and due to this centrifugal force on the vehicle, the wear on the tires occurs. Due to centrifugal force, the pressure on this outer tire is more with respect to this inner edge tire. Suppose this inner edge tire is this side and this outer edge tire is on this side, and so due to centrifugal force the pressure on the outer tire is more, so the chances of wear and tear of tires is more due to the centrifugal force. Now comes to super elevation. Now the question is, what is super elevation? Suppose this is the pavement. Now what is super elevation? You can see this horizontal curve, this is the inner edge of the pavement representing this, and this is the outer edge of the pavement representing this. So to counterbalance the centrifugal force and to avoid the wear on the tires, the outer edge of the pavement elevated at some height with respect to inner edge, and this elevated height is known as super elevation. And why this super elevation is provided? Many times due to forces, the chances of wear are more on the tires. So due to the overturning effect and the skidding effects, and to counteract the tendency of these effects, the super elevation is provided. Now as this is at an angle, so we can resolve this as W cos theta, and this is on negative side, this is W sine theta, and this is P cos theta, and this is P sine theta. We can express this E capital in this super elevation is E, or a small e, and it can be defined as the ratio of outer edge with respect to the horizontal width. Suppose this is O, this is M, and this is N. So super elevation is defined as the ratio of outer edge upon the horizontal width ON, and this can be equivalent to E upon, suppose this is the horizontal width B, E upon B, and this is equivalent to tan theta. If we see by geometry, tan theta is equivalent to perpendicular to hypotenuse, and this super elevation is equals to tan theta. Now friends, it becomes very easy to analyze the super elevation, as we already see in the free body diagram in case of overturning effects and the transverse skidding, that is if the forces acting on the vehicle while moving on a circular curve of any radius r meter and at speed v meter per second, what are the forces acting on the vehicle? That is centrifugal force, that is equivalent to WV square upon GR as we defined in the prior case, and that acts outward through the CG of the body, on the vehicle and what are the next force, that is W, and this W acts vertically downward from the CG of the body, and what are the next, we consider the frictional forces developed between wheel and the pavement contractions that acts transversely along the pavement surface and towards the center of this curve. And also we resolve these horizontal and vertical forces in horizontal and vertical components of the forces. So if we consider the equilibrium of forces, we can consider this P cos theta, the component of centrifugal force, opposed by the W sin theta. We can write it. And what are the or more forces opposing this component of centrifugal force are Fa and Fb. So we can write it P cos theta equivalent to W sin theta plus Fa plus Fb. Now, this Fa is equals to Fra plus Frb, and what we get, W sin theta plus Fra plus Rb. Now friends, we can write this plus, this Ra is opposed by W cos theta, so we can write this Fra is Fw cos theta plus, and this Rb is opposed by P sin theta. So we can write this F P sin theta. Now by simplifying this, P cos theta minus F sin theta plus to W sin theta plus W F cos theta. So now by dividing the equation, above equation, by W cos theta, what we get, P by W 1 by F tan theta, as I have simplified before. You can simplify it by, you can check and simplify by your own. We get tan theta plus F, and what we get, 1 minus F tan theta. And the value of this 1 minus F tan theta considered to be very small, equivalent to 1, and this P by W is equals to tan theta plus F we get. And from this equation, as we have defined the super elevation as tan theta, so what we get, P by W is equals to E plus F, as P is equals to W V square upon G R into W. So we get E plus F, and this W is W is cancelled, and the equation we get in the analysis is V square upon GR, and this is the equation used in the design, and all the questions are solved based on this equation. You can note this equation, and this equation of super elevation is E plus F equals to V square upon GR.
And now friends, we are done with the analysis of super elevation, and in my next video we will design the super elevation. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe.